So perhaps one of the simplest yet most talked about new features of macOS Mojave is dark mode. So dark mode is basically just an on-off switch. You turn it on to get dark mode. And here's what it looks like when you do so. I'm going to go into the Apple menu, System Preferences, and under General, there's just a simple switch here. Appearance, light or dark. Light is what we've been used to. We've been using this for years. It's the basic normal appearance of macOS. You have dark text, usually black text, on a light or white background. Just like here in System Preferences. When you go to dark mode, then you get the opposite. You get light or white text on a dark background. And you can see right here in System Preferences itself, you can see the change, right? You have this dark background and now all the text is in white. But it's not just here in System Preferences. You notice also in the menu bar here at the top as well. But it works in apps also. So let's look at, say, a normal app like Mail. I'll go and bring up Mail and you can see Mail looks very different than what you might be used to. Again, it's a dark background. It's white text. It's in the sidebars here. It's in the toolbar. It's in the area where you read and where you compose new email. You can see you've got white text on a dark background. Now, when you go to other apps, you also can see the difference. Here's Contacts, for instance. Here's Calendar. Notes. Reminders. Even Maps. Look how Maps looks here. It drastically changes the look of the actual Maps itself. The Photos app is going to show you this dark background. Of course, the photos themselves aren't going to change. It's just the background and the text there. Pages, it's similar. You can see the toolbar, the sidebars, a lot of the interface elements are now dark background, light text. But the actual document itself is still going to be represented as you normally see it. You're, of course, creating a document. The idea is it's white paper and dark text. So that's not going to change there. Same thing with numbers. You can see you get all dark interface elements, but the actual spreadsheet itself is still going to have that same look to it. You can customize the look of your spreadsheet if you want, but the document itself isn't going to change. So documents themselves, photos, things like that, they're not going to change. It's the interface elements around them. And when some documents, or some apps rather, have the ability to have like a dark background, like for instance in Notes or in Mail, then of course it will show it that way. But for the most part, it's just really a cosmetic change. And some people may like this, particularly complex interfaces like developers that use Xcode, or if you use Photoshop or maybe Excel or Word, there's tons of options and tons of interface elements. Sometimes people say that it's easier to have a dark mode to be able to see things. Other people like to switch it up, maybe dark mode during some part of the day and light mode in other parts of the day. Now you also have some other options if you go back to System Preferences here. Not only can you go between light and dark, but you can change the accent color. So the accent color you can see clearly here right in System Preferences. It's the little blue color here that's in little buttons and controls. I can choose another color. So I can go through all these different ones. And there's some standard ones you can choose between. You can't bring a custom one. But you can go and at least choose something different than blue. This is useful sometimes when you have an app that actually uses that same highlight cover heavily elsewhere, and having it be that standard blue isn't helping. Maybe switching to a purple is better. Or maybe you just happen to like those colors a little bit better and you just want your Mac to look a little different. So check out these functions in there under System Preferences General. See if dark mode is something that you'd be interested in. I think for majority of people they'll just stick with light mode, but some people may enjoy actually switching to dark mode from time to time, or maybe when using a specific app or doing a specific set of processes, you know, in the evening or in early morning or something like that. It's just a cool thing to be available, and a lot of people have been wanting this for a long time, so I'm sure there will be fans of dark mode.